Okay, let's draw some lines. As a review, this is the equation of a line that you are familiar with. Y equals A plus BX. A is known as the y-intercept, and B is the slope. All right, so let's look at each of these equations and draw them. In the first one, A is 3 and the slope is 1/2. Okay? So 3 is the A and 1/2 is the B. So how to draw this? This is one way. We begin at the y-intercept. Why is it the y-intercept? Because notice, if I put in x is 0, what does y become? Y becomes, just put a 0 in here, y becomes 3. So where x is 0, we're going to go up 3. So I need to create a grid, because there is none. So where x is 0, this is the y-axis. Actually, let's write in the axis too. So this is x, this is y. X is 0, this is the y-axis, y will be 3. So I'm going to put a dot here. So that point falls on the line for the reason I showed you. Another point on the line, actually all the points on the line, are related by the slope. Here's the slope. How do we interpret that? The slope is equal to the rise over the run. So, in other words, it's the change in y over the change in x. This means if I leave the line by a change in x, then I can get back to the line by changing y by this amount. Okay, so whatever the ratio is, it will be reflected in the slope. So let's use the slope given. The slope is 1 over 2. This is the change in y over the change in x. So we're going to change x by 2, beginning on the line. And we know this dot is on the line. So let's start from here, okay? We're going to start from here. So from this position, let's move in the horizontal direction 2 and then in the vertical direction 1 to get back on the line. So 2 over will put us here. And then to get back on the line, we have to rise 1. So I have to go up. And that's where I would put a dot. So here's my second point, and now I can draw a line using a straight edge through those two points, and that is the line. That's line one. Let's repeat this process with line two. Let's begin at the y-intercept. The y-intercept would be 1/2, so that would start us here. Let's put a dot, and then we're going to use the slope. The slope is given as negative 3 over 1. So here it is. I'm going to write it as negative 3 over 1, which is the slope in front of the x. So we need to move horizontally 1, and then to get back on the line, we have to move vertically minus 3, so 3 down. So if we moved over by 1, then we'd have to move 3 down. 1, 2, 3, and that would position our second dot, or second point. Now you just need to join the dots with a line. That's line 2. That's line two. Let's make the last line. Beginning at the y-intercept of 2, we have a slope that connects all the points. We can go from that point over 1 and then down negative 5.5. So this is the slope here. So let's start at this point 2, at 0, 2, and move over 1, which is the change in x. And then we have to get back on the line, we have to go down 5.5. So we're going to move over 1, but then we have to go down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and a half. So right about here. There's the other point. And now I can connect the dots and have my line 3. Line 3 has a steeper slope. Okay, it's a higher number. Even though it's negative, it's the strength of the slope is much steeper. One last thing I want to mention is about how the slopes are used. We use it to draw the line, but we could have used another ratio to get the same line. What if instead of using negative 5.5, I wanted to use negative 11 over 2? Also, this ratio, okay, if I change x by 2 units going 2 over, as long as I also go 2 times of y, which gives us 11. If I go down 11, I'll still get back on the line. Let's double check that. So looking at line 3, if I go over 2, I said, as long as I go down 11, I'll get back on the line. So let's try that. I've moved the graph up so it can fit. So I'm going to start at line 3 on the intercept, move over 2, and now I'm going to go down 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. You see how that's going to fall on the line if I extend the line? Okay, so that's the idea of the slope.